Hi guys, this is called as an EPPO in my language, which means that this is an iron box, and it's a coal-fed iron box that is made entirely of brass. But we still call it an iron box. Why not? If Tony Stark can wear a suit that is made of titanium and gold alloy and call himself an Iron Man, why not call this an iron box? Now, in this video, I'm going to demystify certain things that are associated with this kind of iron box. We're going to look at some pros and cons and how to use this successfully even in day-to-day life when everything is getting electrified. So, let's get to it. It's going to be quite long and boring if we start discussing about the pros and cons of the coal-fed iron box versus the electrical iron. So what we'll do is we'll try to fill it with some coal and fire it up, and then in the due course of time we'll discuss about the pros and cons. The first one being the weight. You can easily use this as a dumbbell because this is quite heavy. This is about 10 kgs, 7 to 10 kgs. But whereas your electrical iron is quite easy to handle, it's less than 500 kilograms, and you also get some portable ones, smaller ones like this, just much lighter in weight.
The coal-fed iron is always kept flat, whereas the electrical iron can be placed vertically like this. The reason being, while in use, it will have boiling coal inside, which will tumble onto one side if you do so, and the heat dissipation will not be even, and there are chances that they might spill out of the vent holes and can cause fire accidents, which is something we never want. In use or not, the coal-fed iron always stays flat. The protective non-stick coating peels off after a few years of use, but the brass iron maintains the sheen much longer and can be polished whenever necessary. These irons are made with solid metal and can last for generations. There might be a simple lock mechanism on this iron which could be a bit different based on the design. It might be tight, no issues. Don't use oil or grease, for the heat will melt it away and it might end up on your fabric as well. You can be liberally brutal trying to open it and it will for sure take the beating. As I open it, you can see there is ash from its previous use which needs to be taken out. I simply empty the contents on a piece of paper. I usually collect wood ash to use as a fertilizer for plants later, or maybe even use wood ash to make soap in one of my future videos. It is better to use good quality charcoal, and you can determine that by breaking it. If it shatters without much effort, you have the good one, and if it doesn't, it is not charred completely and might give out smoke when used. But nothing to worry, the smoke isn't too much and it burns away quickly. That is precisely the reason why I prefer this burning process to be completed outside the house and then take the iron inside. I am breaking the charcoal into smaller pieces and laying it inside the iron. A gentle tap with a metal tube makes everything much easier. To start the fire, I am not going to use any fuel like oil or kerosene. Instead, I use wood shavings. I shave the wood into finer pieces which can catch up fire easily, and lay it on top of the charcoal bed. It looks like a micro bonfire. Note that the goal here is not to make fire. We are going to get the amber, which slowly spreads out on the charcoal, producing immense heat. After a few minutes, the wood shavings burn completely. It takes about 5 minutes or so for this process. And by blowing through the blowpipe, we can see that the fire isn't too much and the smoke is absent as well. I think this would be the appropriate time to close the lid and take it inside. Here it is super important that you don't forget to lock that lid. Once I'm sure the lid is closed properly, I can now carry it inside my house, where I'm going to show you how to iron a shirt using this iron. I am placing this iron on an aluminium sheet. Any metal, ceramic tile, marble or granite, anything could be used for this purpose. And for the ironing surface, I have here a set of some old bed sheets. And here comes the high-tech temperature regulator for this iron, which happens to be a spray bottle filled with filtered water. We spray water on the iron and on the clothes as well. Water weakens the bonds on the fabric, and once pressed, it gives a crisp crease. The iron is heavy and bulky, and hence I wouldn't recommend lifting it often. Instead, sliding it will keep the fatigue down. Moreover, the advantage of the weight here is the fabrics get pressed at the first contact. From here on, pressing the fabric is simply straightforward. At any time during this process, if you feel the heat is too much, you can always bring it down by sprinkling some water. The heat rises gradually, reaching a peak point, and then comes down gradually. So you might want to keep the cotton material for the peak phase. Simple planning can make your work much easier. From here on, you can take all the safety measures you normally would do with an electrical iron, like not leaving it on the fabric or touch the hard parts, etc. So this is how you use a coal iron. No, I'm not telling you to throw your electrical iron and switch over to this iron box. I'm just saying, if you get an opportunity to work with one of these, you know how to do it. And let's not get into the argument of this thing is not safe for the environment, the greenhouse effect, smoke, carbon dioxide, blah, blah, blah. The smoke coming out of this is going to be much lesser compared to what is going to come out of your vehicles or those huge chimneys. I do understand that electricity is clean, but it is clean only if it is coming from renewable sources like wind or water or solar. But most of the time, we are burning fossil fuels, which is again leaving carbon print on the environment. I think this is quite economical because for the cost of 5 rupees, I could press about 10 or 15 sets of clothes. The versatility is you can use wood logs or you can use even coconut shell as a fuel in this particular iron box. So now you know how to use iron box. Maybe you can give it a try. I hope you like this video. I'll be back with another interesting video very soon. Until then, bye. If you really like this video, you can click on my channel icon and it will take you to the subscribe page. And if you don't like it, I do have more interesting videos on my channel to persuade you. Thanks for watching.